Here we are in Washington, D.C., myself and Derek Bolt.
On the mall with the mall. The dysfunction behind us.
So it's the day after your big contest, your first ever.
Yep.
How'd you do?
I only placed fourth, but I am really proud of myself.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I brought together a package that I am incredibly proud of for the stage, and I was in the best shape of my life, and I'm really excited to learn more and get better at it.
Yeah, I mean, I was backstage with you for the whole day, and it was really interesting to see what goes on behind the scenes at a bodybuilding show. So what have you learned from it?
I mean, I knew this kind of going into it, but it's a lot of prep work, and you spend, I don't know, 5 minutes on stage the whole day, and you've spent literally like 6 months getting ready for this contest.
So when you were waiting in the wings and they called your name and you walked out on stage, what was going through your head?
I was definitely a little bit nervous, not because of the crowd. I'm not really afraid of them and I couldn't even see them from the stage. It was just, I put together a really complicated routine and I wanted to nail it as well as I could. And that actually ended up, that nervousness messed me up a little bit because I went way too fast.
But in a way, that didn't necessarily matter other than personal satisfaction, right? Because...
Yeah, and we learned this. The final routine doesn't actually count it towards your score at all. So I spent all that time making this awesome crowd-pleasing routine that showed off my muscles super well and showcased my personality. And unfortunately, it didn't count towards my score at all because it was all judged in the morning.
Dynamic, super energetic, super creative. You got the biggest spontaneous reaction from the audience, and that's not me being biased. What happened in the morning when you were just doing the compulsories is the whole of what guaranteed your place.
100% of the score.
Yeah.
So
I did not know that either, and it's kind of disappointing.
Mm-hmm. And I think that's part of what played into my placement, because I was actually one of the leanest out of the entire bodybuilding division. Mm-hmm. And I definitely had a lot of size for my height, for my weight. So I was really proud of the physique that I brought. But because I'm so new to it, I really need to work on my posing more. And even Mikey noticed, like, while I was up on the pre-judging, I did my double biceps like this with my elbows back. And he noticed every single other person on the stage had them right here, and it makes it so much better.
Yeah, you look so much wider when you bring the elbows forward.
And just minor tweak, but that can be the difference between having the better physique and coming in a place or two lower.
Yep.
And the cool thing is I can ask the judges for feedback.
Uh-huh.
Coming up at the end of next week when the stage photos are released. And I'm really excited to see what they say about me, because the staff was all really excited about having me there, so.
Yeah, they're all really sweet. They liked you a lot. But, I mean, it was a really well-run show, I think.
Yeah, for a beginner, I was ecstatic because when I registered, they emailed me, then they emailed me about the music, then they sent out an email the day before saying, this is the order of events, this is what you're going to do when you come to weigh in, this is what you're going to do Saturday morning, this is what you're going to do Saturday evening, this is how it's all going to go. And they really made it easy to go into this not knowing what to expect, because they told you exactly what to expect.
What did you do to celebrate when you came off stage?
So, first thing first, water, because after a certain point you're so dehydrated, that's all you freaking want is just water. And then Mikey had my king-size pack of 4 Reese's cups that lasted about, I don't know, 15 seconds. It was just
about
that.
You were eating them like a duck, just oh.
Yep, so Reese's cups. And then my fiance, Mikey, and his husband, Chris, all went to Silver Diner, which is amazing. Hickory smoked barbecue bison burger with fries and an Oreo milkshake. Oh my God, I was in food heaven. And then when I got home, it was shower, got all the tan off, so I'm just a nice, like, natural looking tan instead of walnut colored, which is awesome. And then I had a giant slice of coffee s'mores pie and a Moscow Mule, because I haven't had alcohol in 8 weeks. And then we went out to one of my favorite gay bars in town and just hung out, had some more drinks, and met up with all my friends to celebrate. It was really good.
Yeah, it was great. I mean, I couldn't wipe the smile off my face. I'm really, really proud for you, everything. I think you did great. I'm biased, thanks, obviously, but like, it's so hard what you did, and you did it so well.
There's about, I don't know, a half dozen things that I had to juggle to make this happen, and I definitely couldn't have done it without Mikey or my fiance there to support me. And I definitely don't think I could have done it without all the support I get online of people saying, I'm really proud of you, you look really great, you're working so hard, and you inspire me. Because having people say that I inspire them inspires me to work harder and push myself to the limit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you've mentioned several times this weekend when it's my turn to go on stage, which is scary but very inspiring. Mm-hmm. I gotta make it happen.
Mm-hmm. He's gonna be amazing. He has the perfect body for classic physique right now. It's gonna be great.
Oh God, so much work to do. I'm gonna make it happen, because when people believe in you, it pushes you forward. So what are your future plans? Where are you gonna go from here?
All right, well, I'm definitely looking at competing more. I'm not entirely sure what form it's gonna be. I could look into, there's actually the same people that organize this contest do another one in November down in Virginia Beach, so I'm considering that. I definitely would stay in the heavyweight division because the light heavyweight starts at 198 pounds, and that's an unrealistic weight for me to get to. I'd be very tiny even if I was shredded, so I don't think that would be a good option for me because of my height. So I'd stay in the light heavyweight for that. But the thing is, I'm very disappointed that my stage presence in the individual routine doesn't count towards my score at all.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm interested in looking at, there's a federation called the WBFF, the Worldwide Beauty, Fitness, and Fashion, that's aimed more at models, and it takes into account your stage presence more. So that's another option.
Mm-hmm.
But there is something attractive to the idea of, like, straight up bodybuilding.
Uh-huh.
Because it's a lot of fun.
And I mean, there is, as bodybuilding beyond the world of the strict competition, there is so much personality involved. And so even if your routine did not count towards your score, you made a big impression on an auditorium which was packed. Like, there was not an empty seat in the house. And like, people who came in there not knowing who you were probably left there knowing who you were. So like, good for your career.
And it's good for us because we're starting to write a book about bodybuilding and fitness.
Indeed we are, so keep your eyes open for that. So why don't you tell people where they can find you on the internet?
Well, I am online on Instagram as Derek Bolt. I'm on Twitter, Derek Bolt XXX on Twitter. I'm on Tumblr, which is just a slave of my Instagram. Please don't really worry that much unless Tumblr's the only platform you have. And that's about it for now. I will be showing up on Mikey's channel occasionally.
Yeah.
And look for our upcoming book.
Yeah.
Mikey Strong and Derek Bolt make StrongBolt.
Yes. This is our inaugural statement.
Hey, it gives us accountability to actually make it happen.
Yeah, and there's almost as many people here as there were for Trump.